Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today's video is with a special guest. This is my boyfriend, Sebastian. Hey! We finally got Sebastian in. I finally pulled him around the camera and told him, get your ass down and
get... She dragged me in here.
I dragged him in here.
I was like, no, I haven't got a cut. I haven't shaved.
Yeah, he was tripping. I'm like,
I look grungy.
Okay.
And I'm here now.
So a lot of you guys have been requesting for us to do a boyfriend tag slash get to know me slash this and that. And we figured let's do a get to know us. Let's people know more about me and you, our relationship, where we are now in life, how long we've been together for, who cooks in the house, who cleans, you know, all that stuff that you guys wanted to know. We were really trying to do this like without your guys' help, just like answering the questions kind of on our own or making up our own questions, and it was kind of hard. So we asked you guys on Twitter and on Snapchat for some of your questions, and you guys sent over some pretty funny stuff. And yeah, we tried to answer as many as we could, and we figured it's be great for you guys to get to know my boyfriend and yeah, everything about us. Make sure you give the video a thumbs up, subscribe below, comment even below or below, I don't know where. And yeah, please enjoy the video and yeah.
Hope you guys like it.
Yeah. All right, let's get it going. So let's start off with like, I guess the basics.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so I'm gonna let you go.
So my name's Sebastian. I met Karen when I was 19 years old.
I was 21.
And she was 21.
I was a little older than him, but it's okay.
Which I like.
I like him, yeah. And we actually met on a party bus. But we've been together now for 7 years. And I'm like, I'm still kind of shocked. Like 7 years is such a long time. But I feel like it really hasn't been that long. I feel like we actually been together for like a really long time, but it doesn't feel dreading at all sometimes. Tell him the party bus story, because he'd like to narrate the story.
The party bus story?
How we met that night.
I got invited to a party bus by my really close friends, and I think I was stalking her already on MySpace. I just knew she was like in my hood, lived or partied around my hood, so I would always know that she was there.
I worked at Mac, by the way, which you knew I worked there, and then yeah. I worked part-time at a sushi restaurant, so he would go eat sushi there, and he would see me, and then our friend, that waitress is me, she was like his good friend, so it was an excuse to go see.
Yeah, so she invited me to a party bus, and me not knowing that she was gonna be there,
our friend invited him on a party bus.
Yeah, she invited me, and I didn't know that Karen was gonna be there, and I saw Karen, and I was like, dang time.
Stupid. And you know, that night it was like a crazy party bus going from Temecula to San Diego. And you know, things got heated and
I thought heated.
No. Like, okay, we got f***ed up. Everybody got drunk and
like heated as in sexy.
No, everyone just got really drunk on there. But on the way back, we talked and
danced,
and then
I think they used to call it grind.
No. No,
you super grinded on me.
No, you approached me. Do not.
I approached you, but you grinded on me.
No, I didn't. I had
friends. Yes, you did.
And then you were a creep and I walked away. And then you stalked me for like 3 days after that, bugging me.
Yeah, and I've been with you ever since. So who won? Who won? Who won? Me.
Regardless, I ignored him, and then after that he kept contacting me on
MySpace,
and I wouldn't reply, and then Facebook, and I'm like, this guy, who does he think he is, just contacting me like nothing.
I was like, when thirsty wasn't even thirsty back then.
Desperate.
I needed to see her again, and I did, she had a boyfriend.
Yeah, and after that we saw each other, like I would leave Mac, and then I would see him on the way out from the mall, and then we had lunch at Chipotle, and then this and that. So that's pretty much how we met, and the rest is history.
What did you think about me at Chipotle though?
I don't know.
Other than me being the most sexiest man you've ever
seen. You wish. To me, like, he was so different because he was so young, so he was really, really fun. And that's what I thought. Every time I saw him, like, this guy does good music, he's fun, he's outgoing, and I was kind of like, just like working, hustle mode, like a different, like, Okay, anyways, okay, so one question was, where was our first date?
Is it at Chipotle?
No.
I think it was at Chipotle.
Why you gotta fight with me?
Cheesecake. Oh, that's right. Well, one time we went like on a lunch date to Chipotle.
No, I invited you to Chipotle.
Yeah, it's a lunch date.
That wasn't a date.
It's a lunch date. Come have like a lunch date with me. You said that.
I bought us Chipotle too.
And we got bowls because we both fucking swore we were healthy. Our first date, I remember I finally talked to her and I finally got her number. We were texting back and forth. I think I had like a little razor phone or something like that, or the little chocolate one that goes like that. And
I did have
a chocolate phone. Remember guys, the chocolate phones that go whoop? I had that phone and I was texting her. Click, 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 click. And we finally decided to go on a date. And I used to think like, cause I used to live in Marietta, so I used to think going all the way to Glendale, which is here, like, I don't know, like what, north of LA? Glendale, the Galleria and the Americana was really nice and fancy. And I think I asked her, and I don't think she ever been there before. So I took her thinking I was all badass. But you drove,
I was,
huh?
I was impressed, yeah.
I think you drove. Did I have a car? I had a car.
But I had a Scion at the time, so.
Yeah, so Scion TCs were like sick. So she drove and we went to Cheesecake Factory. That was our first date. And then from Cheesecake Factory, we hung out and then we went to the, Santa Monica Boulevard. And that's it, that was our first date. And then ever since then, she didn't stop texting me.
So yeah, who would have known we would have been here after a party bus, right? So crazy. So if you guys don't know, so I've been in the makeup industry for years and years and years and years. And Sebastian has been doing hair for how many years now?
Like almost 6 years.
6 years, yeah. Since we met, pretty much, he's been doing hair.
Yeah.
And like it started off with like doing hair, and like helping my seminars, and eventually he like became my cameraman and then my editor and this and that. And then, you know, now we actually work together. So a lot of people don't know, but he edits and films all my YouTube videos and my Instagram videos. He takes all my Instagram photos for me and the ones that aren't on my iPhone. Even on my iPhone, he actually takes them for me. But we work, we do everything together, and it's pretty cool. It's really cool working with like your best friend. We do, I have to admit, we bicker quite often.
Yeah. But I mean, who doesn't? Like, yeah. It's just a healthy thing to do.
And knowing that, it's difficult when you're like in a relationship and you're working together and you're living together and, you know, you're trying to balance like a life and everything. You know, we will butt heads sometimes on certain things, or we maybe like didn't agree on something, but I feel like I couldn't work with anybody else but him. Like if it was like someone else, I wouldn't be comfortable or as happy. No, as like, you know, like we wouldn't work the way we do if it was someone else. So I'm really,
yeah,
I'm really excited that we've been able to work together. And I'm telling you guys, it's possible. He can help your man do that. if you guys have a boyfriend and or a husband and you guys want to do what we do, he can train them. I trained him.
Guys, just remember, get really, really low. Get the lowest you can and take that picture.
Yeah, you'll look taller because I'm 5'3 and I look like I'm 5'6.
Yeah, I think it definitely happened like super organically from like, her taking her own videos, like, yeah. On her phone.
On my phone. I used to do my lip videos like this, and I used to get my pencil, and I would watch from, like, yeah, a mirror right here, and he would sit there.
And I would watch her do
watch
it.
He would watch me, and I'd be like, hold on, I gotta get this lip video up. I gotta get it up. And then I just sit there and edit real quick and post it, and he's like, what the heck? He's like, why don't you use a better camera?
So then we got a camera, like a little camera, like digital camera.
And it overheated.
And then, yeah, and then it was like, well, let's step up our iPhone pick game up. So we bought this camera, and it was from that camera to a better camera to this camera.
Yeah.
And it just happened like that. It just really just happened like that.
And I think what was cool is that he really enjoyed doing it. Like, he's very creative. So, like, he's like my creative, I'm the creative director, and he's my creative editor. And like, together, I don't know if that makes sense, but together, I feel like it works really well because we both see eye to eye on a lot of things, but we're so different as well. Like, music taste, his music taste is such on point compared to mine. Mine is like whack ass shit.
No, you like good stuff.
No, I know, but like, I get it because of you.
Oh,
yeah,
I get it.
He passes me down the music, so.
I get it now. Makes sense.
Yeah.
Have you guys ever had the baby talk? Of course we have.
Of course.
She's my baby. I want a baby from her. Maybe not soon. Maybe later. Maybe it'll be a surprise. It just hasn't came yet. But of course I want my own like little me inside her.
No, but it sounds so terrible.
They know what I mean. Like, I want you to make my baby, of course.
Okay.
Next question.
Yeah, it's definitely with our life right now, the way we work and the way we travel, we want to definitely wait on it. But I mean, like, if it were to happen, we'd be so happy and we'd be super ecstatic, and I'm sure our families would be as well. But we're definitely not planning anytime soon at all. But in the meantime, we have Ollie. And then I have two little nephews that are 2 and 4. And then I have a niece that's 2 months. So to me, those are kind of like our babies. When we go over, we watch them and we hang out with them. And it's tough. It's really, really tough. So shout out to everybody. And who is the mom and dad out there. It's not an easy job, but you guys are killing it.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, so maybe one day.
Yeah, one day.
How do you guys maintain a healthy relationship? Are you guys a jealous type? How have you guys managed to stay together so long?
Pretty good.
So first and foremost, we are both not the jealous type at all. I think we used to be. in the beginning.
Yeah, I think everybody kind of develops that, especially if you're with somebody when you're young and then you just get with them. I think you just automatically develop some sort of jealousy, yeah. Especially when like she's very attractive or he's very attractive. I think organically you get jealous.
Yeah.
But now we're definitely not.
I have to admit though, when we first met, we used to get in like stupid fights. Like, I don't know. He didn't text me
back.
Where are you? Who are you talking to? I'm gonna go through his phone at night when he's sleeping. Like,
what the fuck is this?
We met really young, so for us, we did, like, we've been through it all, and I have to admit that, like, in the beginning, we were both pretty jealous because it was like a new relationship and you kind of wanted them for each other, but you also wanted to be like, I'm hot shit, I can do this on my own. And it was hard at first, and now it's like, it doesn't faze us anymore. Like, I don't feel like I'm that way anymore, neither are you. We just don't.
I feel like once you're with each other for more than like 2-3 years, you get over this hump. And that hump comes with that jealous hump.
Yeah.
And you go over it, and it's an obstacle in your relationship. And get over a lot of things now, and you just move on, and you just become more mature. But other than that, we weren't that jealous. Now we're completely
not. I was.
Well, yeah, because I'm super attractive.
He's so stupid. How we managed to stay together for so long. I think patience is like the main thing, like having patience, because people change, you know, after a few years, and
yeah,
learning to grow with them, and you know, having to accept the way they are, you know, and I think it's a lot of patience and then a lot of just understanding each other and, you know, respecting each other's like views and opinions, and not knowing everyone's gonna be this, like, he's not gonna have the same mentality as I do, so we do things differently. And my whole thing is like, one thing that I think helped us a lot was the whole expectation thing. You can't have expectations from anybody. You can't expect them to, you know, agree with you on things or do this or that. And that's the whole word expectation. That whole word, to me, it's like, you know, you just have to, like, if I want him to say sorry, I'm going to say sorry because he's going to have to say it. And it's like, no, you can't expect that. So you can't expect anything from anybody. And I think that's us. And then I guess just time and going through hardship too, like going through stuff together, I think really made us closer. Because once one hits rock bottom or one is going to be really hard as hell,
yeah,
it's like, you'll know if that person's really good for you, because he's always there for me and I'm always there for him no matter what, whether it's emotionally, financially, whatever it is. It's like we're there for each other no matter what. Yeah. So I think that really
and just going through a lot. And also our families are super cool. Her family is really, really, really cool. And my family is super, super, super cool. So they all get along and everything. So it's perfect.
Yeah, definitely.
Okay. What is it that you guys do that gets on each other's nerves? I feel like if I answer this, she's gonna f*** me up.
Maybe.
You know what you've been doing lately that's been really ticking me off? You've been leaving the house.
With the air on?
No, I don't care about that. And you throw away the trash, which is cool. It's cool.
Oh yeah, with the trash bag.
And you don't put a trash bag inside back. So she's been like throwing away the trash, which is fine. Like everybody does it.
Because you don't do it. That's okay.
No, I do do it. But she'll just throw away the trash and not refill another one with the trash bag.
Because I go.
And so like, every time I come back, I open the trash and I have to do it. And it's something small, but it just really ticks me off.
I think one of the things that annoys me about him, being like a clean freak and like always liking things organized, is the way he folds his clothes is something annoying. He like folds his shirt, like half, like here's a shirt, puts it in half with the arm, the sleeves hanging out, and then he just folds it up and the sleeves stick out. Like, who puts this, roll the sleeves in? Like, what are you doing over here?
I'm just very simple.
So his drawers are a mess, like none of the, like I like my shirts to be organized like in rows. I would at least be okay with them all over the place. No, the way they're folded is like my biggest pet peeve, and then leave drawers open. That's one thing.
I do leave drawers open. I have
a
big tendency.
And then he like, there's always a sock or something sticking out. I'm like, put it in there. So this is from Tatiana. Someone wanted to know, when was the first time I farted in front of Sebastian and how did he react?
Skip this question. I'm going to get so mad. Skip this question. No, I don't want to talk about it.
No, okay, so the first time I farted in front of Sebastian, we were dating for a few months, and he was over at my house watching a movie. And it was on a scene that was really, really like very like suspenseful or something. I don't know what I ate that day though. We were watching and I was sitting just like this with like a pillow right here. And I happened to move. And right when I moved, the TV went to like a very silent part. And I literally ripped the biggest fart of my life. Like not like thinking it was gonna be like, I didn't even expect it to come out, but I thought it was just gonna like go in the pillows and like no one would hear it or a silent one. It was like.
She farted and I felt like something pushed me.
So literally when I moved, it got to that silent part and then it just sounded like and I wanted to die inside. Like I had been together for less than 6 months and I wanted to literally just bury my face and die.
Yeah, and I wanted to leave too.
I literally was like, I made this face and the next thing you know, I started laughing because I was so uncomfortable. I just started cracking up and he's like, did you just fart? I was like, yeah, I'm sorry. And I couldn't stop and I was like, oh my God, oh my God. And I just felt like nauseous and I was gonna like literally cry. But I was laughing because I was so uncomfortable. And after that, it was like, I just kept apologizing and he was like, it's fine. Like he wanted to get
but
over
it. But it really wasn't.
Now I do it all the time. Now I fart all over the
no,
house.
No, you don't.
I fart often.
One thing about me is ask her, I don't fart. I mean, I do, but I never fart in front of her. I think it's so gross that I would do that.
Get over
I would
it.
Be so embarrassed.
I fart and poop. Get over it.
Oh, I know you do. I know you do.
What were my first impressions on Sebastian? When I met him, he had a mohawk and it was red and black, I think. It was like a red, thick ass mohawk, like out to here. And
What was I thinking?
He looked like he worked at like outside of a club, like a club promoter.
Don't say
with
that.
A mohawk.
Don't
and
say that.
He wore like cardigans and V-necks and he was so different from what he is now, but I remember a couple times I was like, oh.
Cardigans and V-necks.
Yeah, I have pictures.
You really just put me under that category?
I got some receipts. Do you want me to pull them out? So one of the questions is, who cusses the most? Probably me.
Her all day.
Not all day.
Yes, you do.
Now I f***ing don't. You mother.
Have you guys ever broken up for a period longer than 2 weeks?
Not longer than 2 weeks. Maybe 2 weeks at the most.
I think 2 weeks at the most. Yeah. And I think this was like what? Like the first year that we were with each other. So.
And we did communicate in between though. Like he would send me crazy messages. Karen, I miss you.
Yeah. You know, pouring my heart out. I would like bump my nah.
No, he would call me with Usher playing in the background. He'd be like, I think about you every day.
So yeah, from what I remember, we have, and you know, now that I look back on it, we should have never done that. It's very childish. Don't do that. But we have, and yes. Next question. Next question is, how long have you guys been living with each other? How long is it now?
Like a year and a half?
Yeah.
A year and a half? Yeah, we waited a while, so a year and a half to, going on 2 years, but like a year and a half.
We waited till everything was like perfect.
Yeah, and a lot of people ask, oh, go ahead.
No, I was just gonna say, like, I was probably gonna say the same thing. Like, a lot of people ask me all the time, like, was it hard or is it still hard? I mean, it's not hard because I've been with her for so long already that we technically, like, we saw each other, like, every day. And we know each other and we're very comfortable with each other. So moving in was actually really exciting.
It was actually beneficial for us. Like,
I mean, yeah, like, I left drawers open or whoop-de-wop or this and that. But yeah, like, you meet halfway and that's it.
I think moving in really helped us out though, because it helped us instead of like having to drive to each other and you know what I mean? Like having to be like, oh, I gotta like spend time with Sebastian today with my family. It's like we moved in and it made things easier, to be honest. And it wasn't really hard. I think the hardest thing was just like for me was moving away from my parents. Like that was the hardest because I was so emotional. And I feel like if I would have moved out when I was younger, it would have been easier. But being older and closer to them, it definitely was a little more rough on me. But it wasn't hard living together either. Just getting used to like habits and things you do and who's going to do this, who's going to do that. And honestly, I can't cook that well. I can cook some things, but not that well. So I think that to me was a little like hard to like, you know, be like, okay, I gotta step up to his mom's salsa recipes and food, and I don't got the swag like hers, so I had to definitely be like, you know what, I can clean really good though.
Yeah, she really can though.
I can clean like, I mean, if I was for hire, you guys would be impressed. I'd be booked. My cleaning gets down.
Yeah, she really knows how to clean, and she's very clean. And she's very OCD, but she's very OCD about cleaning, which is not a bad thing. All right. Sebastian, I've seen you get down to both, but which do you prefer? Banda or reggaeton?
Reggaeton for sure.
Reggaeton.
Oh, good question. So someone's asking, what is our nationality? And we are actually both Mexican, believe it or not. I know I look Asian, and I know he looks, he gets Persian and what is the one?
Just like Middle Eastern
descent. Any kind of Middle Eastern descent. So it's always like people get confused with us. So, but no, we are both 100% Mexican. Mexicana, Mexicano. Hey, viva Mexico!
Alright, so here's the next question. I got this one from my snap. It says, how do you feel about having a bomb ass, spicy, fire ass, chunti, gorgeous girlfriend?
Aww.
That's really cute. How do I feel about her? I'm guessing basically you're saying, how do I feel having I Love Sarai as my girlfriend? Bling!
I'm just caring to him. He doesn't even like...
She's definitely just caring to me. But I understand who she is. And all I can say is that I'm super blessed and proud.
Aww.
And proud of what she's made herself to be. Other than that, she'd still be fucking making me throw away the trash and shit like that.
Sebastian, what's your favorite makeup look on me? This one's asking this.
I don't know how to describe it. Like, I've even told her, like, when I first met her, I liked her because I liked that, like, makeup look. Like, very glam, very girly look. So I like all the styles that she does. But I like it when she just wears, like, brows, like, no fake lashes, nothing like that. Like, because she has long lashes already.
He likes the prime look, which is, like, face beat, nude gloss, yeah. Mascara, and brows.
Yeah, I love that look.
What cleaning duties does Sebastian have at home?
Taking out the trash.
Washing Ollie.
Taking Ollie a shower, which I love. And I feel like I mop a lot.
Yeah.
I think I'm the mopper.
You're mopper, yeah.
I'm the mopper.
You're not the folder, that's for sure. You don't fold clothes.
I definitely don't fold clothes. Mom, I never picked up the way that you showed me. I'm so sorry.
What products of mine does Sebastian like to steal on the low? Alright, so first and foremost, he likes to steal, obviously, sometimes primers. He'll use primer sometimes.
I remember that you gave me a primer one time from MAC when you worked there. And I really liked it because it didn't change the way I looked. Don't get that twisted. It didn't change the way I looked.
It added the smoothing Snapchat filter on yesterday.
It just made my skin
It snatched you.
If Matt is snatched, then sure, I got snatched.
It's snatched. Alright, so someone's asking what exactly does Sebastian do for work, since he does work with me, but they want to know a little more about him.
Yeah, so I do hair. I've been doing hair for a long time and I love doing hair. And I don't think I'll ever leave doing hair because I love doing hair. But I work with Karen literally full time. Like, it's nonstop. We work all day. We create content.
It's 10 o'clock at night right now. We're doing this.
Yeah. We create. We create a lot of content and we just work all the time. And that became very, like I've said it again, like it's very organic for us to work with each other now.
A full-time job. Like, without him, I wouldn't be able to have videos or anything like that because I do not know how to edit at all. I just know how to start the camera, end it, change the battery, turn it off, make sure the mic's on, and do all that. But other than that, like there's a lot that goes into like what we do, and he literally works for me. Without him, it's like I have no production at all. I have no things. So you guys remember, when my videos are running a little late on YouTube, it's definitely his fault because they are filmed. Just kidding.
So
we do work with each other, and that's the thing. I like, sorry, I'm cutting you off. He loves doing hair, and I love that. And as much as I would want him like to take that one extra day off, he went from being full time salon to me literally pulling him from there, being like, please, 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 please. And I didn't want to take him fully from what he does, but at the same time, like, he's so amazing at editing and everything that.
Thank you.
I had to jack him before someone did.
Like she said, I still work at the salon, I still do my thing there, but I do take a lot of my time, and we're here at the house and we just create content, and we work very, 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 very hard. Another thing is that I love doing it. I geek out on all this camera stuff and videography and editing and all that stuff, so it's really cool, and I'm surrounded with a bunch of beautiful people that do it, and it's really amazing the way that works. So
it's a question for Sebastian. They want to know if you have any hobbies, like outside of what we do, like work. Like, what are your hobbies? He loves food. To foodie, he loves trying all all kinds of food. Yeah. When we travel, he will like ask. He just won't eat. Okay, what are the three things you don't eat?
I don't eat amphibians.
amphibians.
Like frogs. I don't eat amphibians. I don't eat reptiles, and I don't eat insects.
He won't if you tell him. We're gonna have frog legs tonight.
I don't f with that. I'm a human. I eat human food. I'm not a f***ing animal.
Gabby on Snapchat is asking, how many shots does it take for you to get drunk?
Of what though?
Whatever.
Just anything?
Anything, and then number three.
I think a good 7.
Oh my god.
Is that a lot?
Yes. Takes me like 2.
So the next question was, Sebas, how does Karen feel about you being so attractive?
Is that a real question? Oh my god. I'm so lucky to have him in my life. I love him so much.
Ah! Okay, so this is the last question. In Spanish, can you tell Karen what you love the most about her? Easy. Karen?
Okay, Dad.
Karen?
You can't look me in the eyes?
Te quiero mucho porque me cocinas huevos con frijoles. Y porque me lavas la ropa.
You sound like Pablo Escobar.
Y porque me lavas la ropa, hijo de p***a. Te amo.
Porque Why does he sound like Pablo Escobar? Literally.
Te amo porque limpias la cocina, el baño. Tiendes la cama. Me levantas a las 7 de la mañana a chingar. Pero todavía te amo. ¡Au! Y te quiero mucho porque eres tan bella. Eres una bella. Alright, go your turn.
My turn. I gotta do it too?
Duh.
What?
Do it.
I gotta do it too. Oh, fuck.
Say something about me that you love in Spanish.
Okay.
You have to sound like Pablo Escobar.
No. Sebastián, te quiero tanto porque eres muy amable conmigo y me das tanto cariño. Me amas mucho. Me protejas. Wait, wait. Okay. It is.
Un héroe.
No, hold on. Siempre estás ahí para mí, mi familia, y el perrito, y limpio su caquita. Y tiras la basura. Y cada año te amo más y más.
Y me pongo más guapo.
No, más feísimo te
pones. Yeah, so there's your Spanish.
Yeah, there you go. I'm so shy when it comes to Spanish because I know, like, I make up words. I literally make up words. Like, I'm like, I don't know. I say weird shit. I just come up with my, I like make like Spanglish words up. I don't know how. And I've always gone away with it. And then I like after dating them, I've come to realize half the words I'm saying are wrong.
She speaks a lot of Spanglish. Get the car y parquearte. That button over there, púchalo.
Does no one else say that? Púchalo.
It's not púchalo. It's empújalo.
Alright guys, well, I think that completes our get to know us. How about, I think the next boyfriend tag is gonna do my makeup. If you guys wanna see that, give this video a thumbs up and we will make it happen. Yeah. Only if you guys want it, so let us know. With that being said, thank you for watching.
Yeah, thank you so much. And I hope you guys enjoyed this.
Yeah, bye guys. Have a good night, or a good day, or wherever you are.
Peace.